Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. incredible. You managed to make it mean something to each of you, whatever it was, whatever it is, or whatever it could have been. And it's like a little piece of timelessness. I was really very touched, very moved, and very proud of the quality time you gave to it, and that you prepared, and that you presented, and that you did it, and that it remains like a kaleidoscope of memories, with each of your playing recomposing the piece in a certain way. I really think that it's very meaningful to observe the intuition that brings you to play a certain note, which is not wrong, it's just not the one that is written. And I appreciate that, because I think that I always tend to find the intuition and then I complicate, as you heard, chromatically and hemiolically and otherwise. But the intent is good. I wish I had written some of them, and I'm really very touched to have heard them alive by you. I have no doubt that after 20 or 30 years, when you will think about this day, you'll go, where the hell that score was? What did I do? I don't remember any of this piece. And it's okay. Most of the composers don't make it to the dictionary. And those who are in the dictionary, nobody knows who they are. So it's very humbling. And so I was very touched that I could hear what it could mean to another human being to play them, and not just what I saw in them when I gave birth to them on July 5th, last summer in our hall. I don't know if any of you were there that day. I know Suchin was there because she was turning pages. But on May 29th, I had an encounter with a pothole on my circus bike. And somehow, I felt very honored today that I could hear it. So somehow, good things happen. And yesterday, during the upper divisional, one of the students of Mr. Battersby played a composition in his honor in MA 405. And I couldn't help but turning myself back to the seats on the top of the bleachers, where usually he holds his coffee, Mr. Battersby, meaning, during this exam. And I couldn't not hear his presence. Somehow music helps for the flow of memories. And it's really very touching, because I tried my best when I was writing them to sound like they're improvised. And so when you embellish them with your own composition in it, you really complete the circle of it. And I will forever remember how well you recomposed them this evening, with such care and attention for the mood, the phrasing, and everything. Some of you even managed to show me they grew their fingers longer. It was just an amazing experience. Unfortunately, most of the time, pianists compose for themselves. So I played a lot of them myself with my long fingers. And I remember my publisher telling me, so who will play them besides you? Not these, but in general. Then when I composed my French art songs, I wrote them for mezzo, because I could sing them when I composed them with my headphones. And I had the guts to sing it in front of IU teachers to show them how to sing it when I was playing it on the piano. So a lot of bittersweet moments, but I must say that this evening was particularly special, because I know we had a very, very difficult semester with the losses of teachers, with the enormous memory of the 10 years of the death of our students from the voice faculty that happened a few days ago. And I always live with the dead anyway in my mind, as I obviously already meant it to you when I spoke only of dead. But you're alive and you brought beautifully alive the piece. So be thanked very much beyond my words and my vocabulary, because it's not very rich in English. But I'm very, very deeply thankful. And I applaud you and absolutely dream to have a group photo around and above the piano.